Hello and welcome to another edition of the RDECOM Update. I'm Raina Williams. Andrika Thomas recently traveled to the nation's capital for the announcement of this year's four national team winners of the eCYBERMISSION competition.
The U.S. Army's eCYBERMISSION program recently awarded its national winners $5,000 in savings bonds for placing first in the national judging competition in Washington, D.C. eCYBERMISSION is a web-based science, math, and technology competition for students in grades 6 through 9. These students compete for regional and national awards while solving issues in their communities. Students presented their projects to a panel of judges. This year's winners were the CFL Quad Cyclers from Iowa, the Sunbusters from Texas, the SBS Bots from Florida, and the Snacks for Education team from Indiana. The Army aims to encourage students to take an interest in the math and sciences through outreach events like eCYBERMISSION. For RDECOM Update, this is Andrika Thomas.
Like eCYBERMISSION, a large part of Army outreach efforts includes encouraging young people to become involved in technology. Andrika Thomas shares another event that highlights this commitment.
The U.S. Army Research, Development, and Engineering Command participated in the 2008 Technology Student Association Conference. The conference provides a venue for its members to compete in more than 60 competitive events based on principles and concepts learned through projects during the school year in science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. Hundreds of students from around the country gathered to compete in Orlando, where they exhibited their technology and medical invention projects. RDECOM held a special interest session where Dr. Michael Doyle, eCYBERMISSION director, spoke about the many Army opportunities for students interested in technology.
It's real important that we are creating future generations that are literate in science, math, and technology, because that's fundamental to our way of life.
At the TSA Education Fair, RDECOM representatives exhibited night vision goggles, the PackBot, and flexible display screens for the students to learn about. Students also interacted with the simulation technology named Sergeant Blackwell and video gaming system America's Army. This has been Andrika Thomas for RDECOM Update.
Now, let's check out two reports from AMRDEC. Here's Mary Ottman.
With all the different unmanned systems that are beginning to make their way onto the battlefield, coupled with the Army's need to reduce logistical and training problems with unmanned systems, there is an increasing need for common handheld controller. The Dismounted Common Handheld Controller Project works hard to meet this new requirement. Brooks Lombardi from the Software Engineering Directorate tells about some of the benefits of having a common handheld controller.
Common controllers, common user interfaces from different platforms reduces training time, and from a logistics standpoint, it reduces the total number of systems you have to support.
The Dismounted Common Handheld Controller Program is using three controllers. The Everest VIT, the Sony PlayStation Portable, both are commercial off-the-shelf products, and the Raven B controller. Each of these controllers can operate a Gladiator, a Matilda, a Talon, a robotic ATV, and a robotic Humvee. The Software Engineering Directorate, the engineers and developers of the Robotics Lab and America's Army were hosts to a robotics team visiting from George Westinghouse High School of Brooklyn, New York. These students and their teachers were given some hands-on demonstrations and shown how the AMRDEC is playing a vital role in helping save the lives of our soldiers through improved training and unmanned systems. The students, calling themselves the G-House Pirates Robotic Team, has competed in the For Inspiration of Science and Technology, or FIRST, robotics competition since 2000. FIRST is a nonprofit organization that aims to generate and encourage an interest in engineering through robotics programs. The time spent with SED personnel provided these students with a greater knowledge of real-world applications for robotics and hopefully the inspiration to continue their education and pursue careers in science and engineering.
RDECOM not only sustains our warfighters, but also the R&D industry and our nation. With the scope of activities increasing at Aberdeen Proving Ground in Maryland, RDECOM took part in a Harford Community College showcase of the technologies here and coming to APG. Stephen Rochette has the details.
The U.S. Army Research, Development, and Engineering Command recently participated in the Aberdeen Proving Ground Technology Showcase. The two-day event featured 30 exhibitors representing the Army, small business, and local government. Several hundred in attendance witnessed presentations on technology transfer opportunities at APG. RDECOM Deputy to the Commander Gary Martin spoke about the importance of reaching out to the community during a period of transformation.
And this brings that entire community, folks who are currently here at Aberdeen, those who are coming together to express what these changes are, what the new business opportunities are going to be, and give folks who are coming down an opportunity to see what the environment in the local community is like.
RDECOM elements at APG and Fort Monmouth showcase several technologies, including the Toughbot, conceptual animations, and Army Power Innovations. In his keynote presentation, Martin addressed APG 2012, a vision for the future of the installation as unmatched in the Army with its support to the warfighter.
But 2012 signifies not the end of BRAC, but really the beginning of our transformation as an Aberdeen Proving Ground, one of the three major acquisition communities in the Army and AMC. And from my perspective, it'll be a place like no other.
Reporting for RDECOM Update, this is Steve Rochette.
That does it for this edition of the RDECOM Update. I'm Raina Williams reminding you to make sure you do something to support the warfighter today. Thanks for watching.